lawyer for the Dipale family, says they are seeking justice and want to find out the truth of what happened to their loved one.
The family actually of Dipale indicated that they think that they will find justice in the opening of this inquest and probably closure in this matter. Hopefully they will know how Ernest Dipale died.
The investigating officer in this matter says they were able to trace the sequence of events leading up to Dipale's death, that he was involved in a car chase and shooting with police a day before his arrest, but that some critical documents and files were found to be missing.
There was a statement of Warren Lusagetes who reported this accident at the Morocco police station, and him Juma Masela as the driver of the motor vehicle that was pursuing the deceased. And there was a shooting happened, but the car that was driven Mr. Dipale was not hit, they were not injured. Warrant Officer WCC Smith, he's the same warrant officer that is involved in the Dr. Nilagit matter. That we managed, despite our best efforts, we cannot trace him.
Dipale's sister gave an account of her interaction with former apartheid government spy and assassin Joe Mamasela.
My sister-in-law was talking and looking to this black policeman and said, "Joe, is it you?" And then he just dropped his head and said nothing. And then she continued to say, "Mwabi has not killed himself." So we never believed that he killed himself.
The inquiry continues. Nozindombi Mia, SABC News, Johannesburg.